My name is Anubha Sharma. I'm an ex-financial services professional. I grew up in Calcutta and I worked in Delhi. I moved to Mumbai in 2007 in a national role, like I said, within the financial services space. Then, but in 2011, I decided to take a year off after 20 years of working in the corporate sector. I was bored. I was a little unwell and I wanted to just get a change in my life. So whilst I was enjoying my break, I was also a little bored. So I was looking for opportunities to do something different and experience different things. So I started trying volunteering. And eventually I landed up at this street school on Carter Road, where I used to see children every morning sitting on mats and studying and some older people teaching them. So I went up to this gentleman one day and I asked if I could bring breakfast for the kids. He kind of convinced me to start teaching instead, which I was very apprehensive about, having never taught any children and not having had much to do with children apart from spoiling my own nieces and nephews. But I started to go there, and once I did, I really started to enjoy myself. Those kids were very entertaining, to say the least. And but it was sad at the same time to discover that they knew so little. They've been going to school for years. Some of them were in grade 6, 7, 8, and they knew precious little from their books and about the world. So it seemed a little unfair that these kids don't get to learn much. And one was wondering as to how they would ever make something out of their life, even despite the fact that they're getting the so-called education, because the education hasn't really done much for them. And I think our kids learn so much from us besides what they learn from school, and they didn't seem to have that advantage. But what could one do? Like, I did what I could. I started going there every day and I said, okay, I will continue to come here till I go back to work. So education is not the only thing that is missing from the lives of these children. Most of them are malnourished. They don't have adequate possessions, including clothes. So one day, early morning in January, I have one child telling me that, can I sit in the middle? I'm feeling very cold. And I just looked around and most of the kids were in t-shirts. Half of them had something warm on. Half of them were just like that. And a lot of them were shivering. So the next day I put up a post on Facebook asking for warm clothes. I generally described what I was doing. And I said that if anybody has good warm clothes in good condition to give away, to give me a call. So this actually set in motion the incident which led to how Angel Xpress started. I had 3,000 people calling me over the next 10 days, offering me help of all kinds, and that included my partner and co-founder, Bina Advani. So it was a little overwhelming to begin with, but it made me realize that people have this desire to give, to do, to just do something, but they don't seem to have an outlet. Like, you know, somebody asking for some little thing who they seem to trust, and they were like really wanting to go out of their way to do stuff. So there was this realization, but at that point of time I didn't really think much about it. So but soon after that I did a small party for the kids. I said, let people who've been calling me come and see, those of whom who want to come and see what we're doing. So there was this 26 Jan flag hoisting happening. Some magician had called me, some clown had called me saying that we can do stuff. So I just invited everybody to come and visit. And one of the people who had called me was Jackie Shroff, and he also came, landed there, and he was there for 2 hours. So I have a spiritual guru for 10 years now, and I happened to mention this incident to him. So I told him what had been happening and that I did this. And this was a time when my year was almost getting over, when I had actually started thinking of going back to work. And because the financial markets had crashed, I thought that, okay, I'm going to sit out for another maybe 6-8 months, go visit my parents and then come back and then start again. So he just looked at me and he told me that you're not going to go back to work. You're not going to go back to Cal. You're just going to do this work for your life. And I said, what? I'm going to teach 5 kids all my life? You've got to be kidding me. What about my career? Who's going to pay me? But because he'd said this, I started to think about what can be done. I started to talk to various people and I started to understand the education space and put in a little bit of effort. And then when Bina told me that she wanted to set up a project like that in her school, I said, okay, let's do this as a project and see where it goes. So her school shut down, but Angel Xpress started. The idea behind Angel Xpress was that I see the people who want to spend time with children as angels, because That's what an angel's job description is, to help others. And I see these people as those who are willing to go beyond themselves to help and to care, provide care. And I think that's what our volunteers are doing. Xpress is to denote speed. So we're trying to put some kind of speed and direction into the lives of these children. So that's how this name came to be. Angel Xpress is about creating a better future for everyone, for yourself, for your child, and for these children. I think every child deserves an opportunity to be empowered. And I think that's what we're trying to do over here, for the child to be able to understand how to be able to live his life in a way that he doesn't feel become a victim of the system. So you're helping not just an individual and several individuals to live a better life, you're also creating a better life for your own and your child's own future world. What the world will look like will be a better place. So it's not just what you're doing, it's also what you're going to get back. You'll get back a lot of contentment, you'll get back a lot of satisfaction, you'll get a lot of love from the kids. You'll get a lot of fellow people around you who will be sharing the same ideals, same ideologies, and it's a very family feeling when you connected to people who feel in the same way. And there's a lot of, and I think as an individual you grow, because we try and have many trainings and many different kind of experiences for the volunteers. And it's not just about learning how to be a better teacher, it's also about learning how to be a better individual. So there are a lot of self-awareness activities that we try and create experiences around. So I think it's a fun place to be, and I think you should give it a shot. Maybe you'll like it.